have your news previews, the highlights, and much more coming up in this week's edition.
That's right, and plus we'll have another special segment planned out for the show today. Before that, we'll be alongside Jeff and I, the guests for some upcoming baseball season talkers.
Can't wait. So let's get right into the action as Kerri starts her off with the women's basketball team, whose top is Western Kansas. Kerri has more details.
All right, the women's basketball team's up on a danger of the top bowler, Regan, and once again had three players reach double figures. The women's basketball team has been on a roll with the help of Brady Wilson, who scored 28. Now he's up in with 14 points to James Kulich, who drained 10. Rana Campbell had 9 rebounds, 4 steals, 2 blocks, and 2 assists. Her blocks tied her for 6th place on all the single season record. The Explorers won the tip off, and it was a flash in the future as they remained on top the entire game. Despite the Explorers leading throughout the game, Xavier dominated on the boards 41-30, final score 63-51.
The men's basketball team sported the color pick to raise awareness for this cancer this past weekend, but dropped yet another heartbreaking loss to St. Louis 59-51. The Explorers tallied early in the first half, but were plagued by 20 turnovers, which became the second most in a single game all season. Freshman Jarrell Wright added a game high 18 points and now he got to the loss, which snaps the Explorers 14-game home winning streak. Dating back to last season, in January, the Explorers came off a hot 4-game win streak and since have lost 3 straight games to St. Joseph's, Richmond, and the Village this past weekend. LaSalle's record now sits at 17-9 and 6-5 in the Atlantic Conference.
And moving on to lacrosse, women's team kicks off their season against Oregon Ducks this weekend after an upsetting season 4-12 record last year. After only losing 1 starter from last season, Brittany White, the team closes into the season with a strong group of athletes. According to the coaches, the experienced defense will play a pivotal role in the success of the season.
Moving on to track and field, our very own Explorers men's track team flourished at the Middle Rose Games this past weekend, proudly overstepping the University of Albany for 3rd place. The talented distant medley relay team of Paul Riley, Wayne Bartholomew, Terrence Lafitte, and Nick Chris ran their hearts out. Riley began well-prepared race with a 1,200-meter dash and handed off the baton to adrenalized Bartholomew, who positioned himself for 400 meters ahead of the race. Lafitte, the only senior out on the team of the juniors, kept LaSalle of the pace with invigorating 800 additional meters. Golden Blue prestigiously crossed the finish line with Chris after a strenuous 1,600-meter leg with a final time of 9 minutes and 48 seconds. This was a prideful placement for the Explorers. Really, Bartholomew, McTeague, and Chris, and the rest of the side Explorers, were not able to get to beat the rest. This Friday and Saturday, they hold the Leg 10 Championship in Kingston, Rhode Island, where our Explorers will be back in action for victory.
All right, let me get back to the break. We'll have more Explorer news and previews. The baseball player will be talking to us about the upcoming season and the first game against Buckingham.
I wonder who it's going to be. And don't forget, later on this show, Adrian Grove will be sitting down with Explorers athletes. Stay tuned. This past weekend, the men's track team took their talent to the inaugural Charles Torbee Invitational at the University of Rhode Island. Just minutes after the emotional ceremony to commence Charles Torbee, the men and women Explorers set a tone with a convincing 4x800 medley relay and victory. The men's team won with a combination of Bartholomew, Loretta, McPeach, and Riley once again. For the women's team, victory was Dwyer, Hutchinson, Storbeck, and Walker. Nick Chris continued his very strong indoor season with a victory with the 1,000-meter race. His time missed the school record by 0.8 seconds, also posting a big win for the Blue and Gold with Paul Riley, who won the 800-meter race just seconds before his teammate Brett Shepard. Both the men and women Explorers will be back in action just 2 weeks from the next held at Maxwell Fieldhouse.
All right, this winter weather has been the baseball team's favor as they were able to practice outside for quite some time. All the practice has been helping the team prepare for the upcoming division tournament. The first match of the tournament against Buckingham, head coach Mike Lake said that the team is excited for the start of the season, and the warm weather has been a huge help while preparing for the season. Lake was also a big five coach of the year and bringing his team to the A-10 tournament twice. Hopefully, the Explorers can dominate and come out on top this season.
Well, it's time for another quick break, but when we return, we'll be joined by the world's men's baseball team.
That's right. Don't forget that right after the break, Adrian Gore will be sitting down with 4 athletes. We'll be right back.
Thank you. baseball, we have Taylor Roman of the men's baseball team here to join us. How's it going, Taylor?
Thanks for joining us. So, we have a big game to get stuck out of the game for the tournament. How do you guys to prepare for it?
Just a lot of defensive work. There's a mental rely on their squads. Basically, just trying to get ready to help with all the I guess, teams and outs that teams are coming up. So, it's just easy to go for that. There are a lot of teams that have lost about the blood. So, talk about how the team that came in forward overall. I'm going to get just like the people just finally they got it here because obviously the full week guys just preparing for every game. So, I'm trying to come.
Yeah, well, these two or three weeks, you know, we get back forward right now is the hardest because we're all burnt out in the fall. We're ready to start the season. And, there's just a lot of mental focus that really needs to be there for all of us in order to prepare for the opening game.
Now, the warm weather, how is that going to be favored? Because the other schools, they can practice all year right now, whereas we can't because of the weather. How's that work?
Yeah, well, we go to the facility to prepare and get swings in. There's a swim ball panel. Guys work on the field. The basic fundamentals that, you know, every player needs to have in order to stay.
Now, can you just remind
me of
what the
distance
time?
I'm a release pitcher.
And you're not from around here, right?
No, I'm from Chandler, Arizona. I definitely don't have to wait. Of course, you know, in Philadelphia, we obviously have to wait. Yeah, I was short, so I wouldn't break for the most part.
Is it a hard transformation to come from the Arizona
where
you're here in Philadelphia?
Well, you know, first of all, freshman year was pretty difficult, not having a whole lot of one course, but I think being here for, you know, 4 years has been my advantage, and I think getting used to the money that just likes to play.
Did you know anyone coming to the Salle or you're Philadelphia Big Five before you actually were interested in this football?
No, I kind of applied to schools all over, you know, the country, region by region, and I might have been the first guy west of the Mississippi to find a Salle, and now recently we've had three more guys from California come along. So it's been pretty cool.
What made you pick LaSalle? Was it the person that accepted you? Did it come for baseball? Like, how did it work?
Frankly, I got the most money in general. That's the thing.
That was the decision. You know, I got money academically for baseball, and my parents, you know, were stressing, you know, probably since I was 15 to go far away. So that they kind of wanted me to get out of the same high school that I've been
in.
So. Yeah, okay. So moving back to the big point now, so you say that you're a relief pitcher. Whose game do you say that you're favorable to any type of reference to get into the mix inside? What do you do? If someone is the pros, or like someone you've always been looking up to, what do you be playing it out on top?
You know, that's tough to say. You know, because I changed my name a few times since I've been in college. Really, it's hard to tell. I'm a side arm. So, there's not a lot of famous Salle pitchers out there.
You're not a
Phillies.
You're not a Phillies
fan, are you? I don't know.
Something embarrassing that feels like having a joke in the talk to or tripping or something as you go out on the field. So it's something, you know, try to keep it fun, I guess, you know, especially when it comes to grinding.
So going back to that, actually, somebody asked me to get 6 points on the dot. Maybe some of like your short term as well, long-term goals for this season upcoming. You guys, I'm just thinking consecutive games and changes your first last year. Unfortunately, you had a hand that you didn't expect it. You spoke about some things you had coming up for this season.
Well, I said, you know, we'd like to win 30 games. You know, Coach Lake has been preaching since he got back. 56 wins. You know, that's the goal, is to win every game. But obviously, in baseball, you know, anybody can beat anybody in the day. So we'd like to try to, you know, we'd want to win most of our series, but not all of them. And hopefully, have a top seed in the tournament to make life a little easier on the pitching staff because it's was supposed to succeed to honor our team to them being successful.
Who is going to be your toughest competition?
The side out of first I probably from the University of San Diego. I think that's what got west in middle mental this year. But at conference, four of us always suck. We don't like each other. You know, that's the thing. Yeah. We played each other tough the last, you know, 2 or 3 years. And we eliminated them 2 years ago in the attempts, but I meant to be, I guess, that kind of sparked a little bit of the rivalry.
Probably
there's about a third of us that have been that much of a tour on our side. There's a lot of guys today.
Yes, that also came on the show. That's why I said, that's a big thing that we got to see guys in the team as well.
There's a bunch of Tony, Mark Stuck, Frank McCoy, John Donald, Eric Van Wick, Kevin Christie, Matt Fires,
Steve.
A lot of guys, yeah. I know I'm forgetting some, but.
I've seen Frank Christie with the Mohawks, because you guys all have the Mohawks, the mustaches. Now, what's up in your home games at home opener? What do you guys do?
The home opening series is called Stash Bash. So if you guys ever want to come out, bring your mustaches. It's just been people all the time. It's kind of a tradition to start, I think, maybe, you know, 3 or 4 years ago. We just try to keep white, change that, and change that. And I'm just thinking, I'm all for the team that doesn't have mustaches. Or the team is that the guys that can't grow mustaches more than anything. Mm-hmm. I'm a little freshman, I guess. But I don't know, because I figure out how to grow it. Force it out, you know.
Good luck with
the
tournament against
Buffalo.
Thanks for
coming on the show. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Well, it's time for another quick break, but when we return, we'll have your news preview highlights.
And don't forget, right after the break, you're going to be sitting down with Rachel Reeser from SportsLine. We'll be right back.
Hey, Rachel.
Hey, Corrado.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. Good.
With women's football player Rachel Baker. Rachel, thanks for being on the show. Once again, here on the show. Let's get started right away. The 2012 season opener versus Oregon. That's a big game. They're very big coming into the South territory. Talk about how last season will affect coming up to this debate.
The new thing we're kind of trying to do is have a little more pride in our stadium. So we want to protect this. So we're excited to come to Salle Athletics. We have known that our time weren't ready, and we really want to protect the front of the senior. So
let's talk about the cards a little bit. You guys won one game last season with a devastating 4-12 record. How crucial is this to come up with the win of this first game?
Well, it's not very competitive. It's a great season. I think the majority of it flows, so it's important to take the before that, I didn't have the time experience to prepare for that. We weren't prepared to win. We didn't have a good record before, so we weren't necessarily confident that going into a conference game. So we really want to come up with a nice thing and win our first beat. The first one I think we can go with the beat at a conference. So that's what we're striving for. We just want to do as much as we can. We're going to find as much as we can that we can set that.
And working on those two things together, why do you put it into the next question? And do you know what it's coming from next season? How is that
going to
affect the team?
We got really lucky as a senior to have 10 new girls come in and play over. We have lost 3 players last year. So we have great competitors that are freshmen up now. We have 2 freshmen now, 5 freshmen that are definitely going to start. They're going to be key scorers for us. And everyone else are contributing as well. So just having fresh legs because we're all getting older. So having fresh legs and fresh mindsets and just scores, I think it's going to make us take on more.
But you are sticking this year. How is this going to be different than playing as well?
My senior class, for some senior, my class, we're the only group of people that have come in and are 7 that were recruited. We haven't lost anyone, no one's quit, no one's done anything like that. So we're very close. And we all have the same goal. We've experienced Asian championship, we've experienced being good, we've been there at the bottom. Like, season, we only won 4 games, so we definitely want to play well, we want to succeed, and I think that everyone else really wants to do that for us. They understand that this is all we have left, so I think that that really helps with the leadership, having our spots to get to be sick, having girls that want to do it for you. So,
and speaking of your expectations of goals, what are your expectations for this season?
More than anything, I think the last thing that really caught us was looking too far left. Right now, our only goal is to be Oregon on Sunday. And after the Oregon, our next goal is just going to be just going to play well the next weekend. And we want to take it really one step at a time. And I think does and our coaches that really sets up for success if we stick to the game plan and we'll start across the game plan, we'll be fine. So I think our expectations are just to come out having a good day and play with intensity and just kind of have each other's balance and everything else will fall into place instead of setting. We obviously have goals. I'm extremely disappointed because we don't end up with a big championship, but I'm not trying to think about that yet. But it's kind of just one step at a time.
Over the years, where's the best place to go for them and where's the best place?
My coach was 20% next year is youngest, but we fall between a lot of different level of play and different things. I just think it's a great canvas. The field's actually up. It's like we're in the middle of the city. It feels really high by now, so the view is beautiful. I love playing. I wish that they were like a more flexible way to just go to the they have the whole body concept, I guess, so kind of just you have to stay in a lot of bubble to make contact, but it's kind of like you don't wear any pounds or anything, just goggles and that's what I'm trying to keep us under control of that.
Okay, and actually, I have a question. What's your most favorite role in the
game? The two roles that just introduced this to you, that's kind of like a power flex platform. You have to manage the clubs, so if there's any sort of yellow card currently on the field, then there's one player from the field and one used to have, and then you could send someone over there just training on them if you don't have these, and so they can still be 77, but now it'll be 67 kind of like NCAA rates.
Okay, and you can explain a little bit what the restricted one is.
Across the 11 players in the field, you can have it. If you're 50 out of line, that each side is a 50 base to restrict on it. It's getting played out, but I have to see my favorite thing that's ever happened. It's my stop for a year. We are playing New Mexico at last week this season. We just got out to make a big time tournament, and we were struggling to get past New Mexico here. It was 4-0, and down by 4, and then we kind of came back to the second half. I think there was a minute left, and we were down by 1, and our coach called an after play for a long time, and she ended up scoring. I think it's 16 seconds on the clock.
Looking forward to the next game, where can we see you 5 years from now? Are you going to be coaching and still be playing in the league?
Unfortunately, this is not. There are very many places to go for coaches across after this. I might go to school and somehow use the cross country of guys to sit with that and fancy myself coaching. Plus, I'll coach cancer fire, so you can see it's not here in the cross, but I know that I can see myself coming to something
like that. All right, well, I want to say good luck to you, please, and for SportsLine, I can just say with Rachel Brayton, I'm going to be close to you. I'm going to go right now, right back to you guys, and it's look good.
Putting aside your blue and gold colors for cancer awareness and donating to the warm-up and selected to the athletics department. We'll be donating ribbons for $1 and accepting donations to the Kerri Foundation in honor of breast cancer. Come out and help support the explorers and donate for a great cause. Today I'm also moving on. You can't get a ride to the upcoming night's basketball game. That's no problem because we'll Salle is providing a bus for all its fans. The bus will travel to Fordham and George Washington, which fans don't have to wait for these tours to just play at the time of the race. Each trip would cost about $50, and that would include bus, food, ticket, admission to the alumni reception, raffles, and prizes. So go to sportsdale.com for money deadlines, and
Well, let's look ahead to see what this four-hour squad has coming up. On Friday, the men's and women's track and field team will be competing in a leg tech tournament in Rhode Island. The event will take place all day and will see into Saturday.
And on Saturday, the baseball team will race bus down with the Dignity Tournament in Rhode Island, which will set for 12 o'clock today, the second game of the day, and the season at 3:30.
Also on Saturday, the women's basketball team will play Duquesne away at 12 p.m. Make sure that you check out those last stats.
And the men's basketball team will take on UMass at 6 o'clock.
And last on Sunday, the baseball team will end their tournament with a game against Niagara at 10 a.m.
And the girls will be back in action first game of the day, Oregon at 1 o'clock.
Finally, the women's tennis team will compete at St. Peter's at 1:30 p.m.
Well, that's it for this week's edition of SportsLine. Don't forget, you can visit GoExplorers.com anytime for the latest in LaSalle Athletics. And be sure to send us your comments and suggestions to LaSalleTV@LaSalle.edu. And don't forget to check us out on the web for more and other showtimes at more at LaSalle.edu/LaSalleTV.
Well, thank you for joining us this week for Kerri and our entire SportsLine team. I'm Justin Walters, and we'll see you next week.